Friends, this is Pete, K7PP, and we're going to add a little extra comment to the alignment of the HQ180 alpha, and this would probably apply mostly to the alpha series Hammarlunds, the 170s, the 180s, and we're going to be doing a fine tune or tweak or hack or whatever term you want to apply. This is something that would be outside the normal service manual instructions, and something that would improve the actual notch characteristics of the radio. And the reason that it only applies to certain models is because if you get in a little bit closer here and take a look, you'll notice that yes, there is a slot adjustment in the upper right hand corner. Below it is the BFO adjustment, and below that is the vernier tuning, which is a band spread adjustment for the receiver. And the thing is that these particular radios came with retrofit kits. Later on down the road, they determined that the 180 could benefit from several options, and one of those options was to add a vernier tuning down here in the right side. And so what they did was they reconfigured everything so that they moved the slot controls around. Right here where we see BFO kilohertz, that used to be slot depth, and that no longer is. The slot depth control, hope I don't make anyone dizzy, can be easily seen right there. They mounted a little L bracket right on the side of the capacitor that adjusts the slot depth. And what they did was they pre-adjusted that and just left it be, no matter what you did from there on in with the slot depth frequency, why that control remained inside the radio and untouched. So the bottom line is, some of the receivers that you might have don't apply. For instance, this Hammarlund HQ170 has got a slot depth control right there on the front panel, and that's the one we just looked at inside the Hammarlund 180 alpha as being mounted on that little L bracket. This one's right on the front panel, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to look at the service manual. And the service manual down here in step 4 says turn the slot frequency control to 0 and slot depth control to its mid position. Set L3 for minimum meter reading, and it may be necessary to raise the IF input level to make sure that the indication is absolute minimum. Okay, now if any of you watched any of my previous videos, you'll realize that this is the Hammarlund HQ180 that I just got through aligning, and I followed the instructions per the book exactly, and this is what I ended up with. I've turned on my crystal calibrator, which is a really ferocious signal on this band, and you can hear it, you can see it on the S meter, and if I adjust the slot depth right up here for minimum on the S meter, you can see it does notch, start to notch. And there's our minimum right there. Now, the problem being is that with a little bit of finessing, we can get a much deeper notch. A much, much deeper notch. And so I'm going to reach inside here and hopefully not get electrocuted. And I'm going to adjust the slot depth frequency, and I'm going to adjust the slot frequency here back and forth. Yeah, I wish I had two hands here. Okay.
really touchy. Okay, there you go. So the point is that if you carefully finesse that control back there, back and forth between the slot adjustment and the control on the L bracket, which is the slot depth, you can achieve considerably more attenuation. We went from probably an S3 down to below an S1, and so what, 6, 12, 24, an extra 24, maybe 25, 26 dB better notch just by finessing that control a little bit. So we're done, basically. If I tune the control back to the far right, you'll notice we're right back up where we used to be. And now when we're going to adjust for notch, we just we go right to it. So anyway, this might be well worth noting that the service manual, while for the most part is a pretty good guide, pretty much neglected to mention this little aspect of the slot depth control. Hope this helps you guys get your Hammarlunds in tip-top condition, and I hope to work you on the air, maybe a little CW. These things really, really are good on CW. Best of 73s, Pete, K7PP. See you on the air.